Dear students, so far we have introduced the test statistics Z, T, chi square and F. As we have discussed in the previous classes, Z test statistics can be used if and only if population variance is unknown. If population variance is unknown, we use the sample variance, then the test statistics is T. Chi-square is used to test the significance of squared quantities. It can be used to test the significance of sigma hat square that we have not discussed so far. Then we have introduced the F. F statistics is used to test a variety of hypotheses, testing a group, the significance of a group of variables, linear equality restrictions, restricted least squares, and so many cases. Now, usually these test statistics are enough. But when we go beyond linear regression models, that is, when we consider nonlinear regression models, these test statistics will not be enough. So, to deal with such cases, that is, to deal with the cases involving nonlinear models, we have to introduce additional test statistics. The three test statistics which we introduce now are likelihood ratio, LR, Wald and Lagrange multiplier. In short form, we write it as LR, W and L. We introduce three more test statistics: likelihood ratio test statistics, Wald test statistics and Lagrange multiplier test statistics. In large samples, asymptotically, these test statistics are same in the sense that the test statistics associated with all these is chi-square. The test statistics associated with LR, W and LM follow chi-square distribution. And remember this, these test statistics are actually used as a complement to the F test. In linear model, F test is enough, but in some cases we may require this. Also, when you use a statistical software like eViews, Stata, etc., you will see Wald F, likelihood ratio, Lagrange multiplier, etc., in specific cases. So, an understanding of what is the essence of these test statistics is essential for reading computer output. And remember this, these are all complements to F. And also remember this, the test statistics associated with these three tests in large samples is chi-square. If you are considering only linear models, then these test statistics are not necessary. What is required is only the F test to test various hypotheses. But as I told you, to understand computer output, you must be aware of what is meant by LM, W and LM test statistics. A formal derivation of these test statistics require matrix algebra, and we will discuss this at a later time. And for an easy reference on these test statistics, the book is Econometric Methods by Johnston and DiNardo. The book provides an extensive treatment of maximal likelihood and these test statistics using matrix algebra. For the time being, we just introduce these test statistics without giving any formal proof. We explain these test statistics in the context of likelihood ratio tests. LR. Likelihood ratio tests. And remember this, the likelihood ratio test and also W and LM are based on the method of maximal likelihood, which we have introduced in the last class. And we have shown how the method of maximal likelihood is used to estimate the parameters of a two-variable model. This can also be extended to a three-variable model or a general k-variable model. The method of ML can be extended to two three-variable model and also the general k-variable model. Now, under the normality assumption that U is normal with the 0 and sigma square. Remember that ML method was introduced on the assumption that each yi is normally and independently distributed. That means ui is also normally and independently distributed with the mean 0 and variance sigma square. We have shown that OLS and ML are one and the same thing. But we have also shown that the estimator of sigma square using OLS is sigma u hat e square by n minus 2. Using ML, it is sigma u hat I square by n. That is the difference. And this is unbiased, so it is biased. And we have also shown that this bias will disappear as the sample size increases indefinitely. That is, ML estimator of sigma square is a consistent estimator. Now, let us, in the two-variable model, yi is equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 xi plus ui, ln lf was written as minus n by 2 sigma square minus n by 2 minus n by 2 ln sigma square minus n by 2 ln 2 pi minus 1 by 2 sigma square sigma yi minus beta 1 minus beta 2 xi the whole square. Now consider the three variable model yi sum of beta 1 plus beta 2 xi plus beta 3 x 2i plus beta 3 x 3i plus ui. Now, the log likelihood function is ln lf is equal to minus n by 2 ln sigma square minus n by 2 ln 2 pi minus 1 by 2 sigma square sigma yi minus beta 1 minus beta 2 x 2y minus beta 3 x 3i the Oscar for the three variable model. Now As in the two variable model, in the three variable model also, OLS and ML are identical. The difference is, in the three variable model, OLS estimator of sigma square is sigma u hat I square by n minus 3. Here it is same as sigma u hat I square by n. That is the only difference. Now, let us assume that H0 beta 3 is equal to 0. Let us assume that beta 3 is equal to 0. In that case, this log likelihood function become ln LF is equal to minus n by 2 ln sigma square minus n by 2 ln 2 pi minus 1 by 2 sigma square sigma yi minus beta 1 minus beta 2 x 2y the whole square. If a beta 3 is assumed to be 0. Now, compare these two equations. Let it be equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now this equation number 1 is known as unrestricted log likelihood function. And equation 2 is known as restricted log likelihood function. This is the unrestricted log likelihood function with the two explanatory variables. When this null hypothesis is specified, this becomes restricted log likelihood function, RLLF and ULLF. Then, to test whether this restriction is valid or not, that is, to test whether H0 beta 3 is equal to 0 or not, we introduce the likelihood ratio test statistics as lambda is equal to 2 into U LLF minus R LLF. Lambda is equal to 2 U LLF minus R LLF. Can also be written as minus 2 into R LLF minus U LLF. Can also be written as minus 2 LN R LF. Not log likelihood function, but likely U LF. So, to test the validity of this restriction, the test statistics is given as lambda is equal to 2 unrestricted log likelihood function minus restricted log likelihood function, or minus 2 into ln restricted likelihood function minus unrestricted likelihood function. Now, the basic idea behind the LR test is, if the restrictions are valid, that is beta 3 is equal to 0 is valid, U LLF and R LLF will be more or less identical. But if the restriction is not valid, U LLF, unrestricted log likelihood function, will be much different from restricted log likelihood function. Now, we can show that lambda in this specification is distributed as a chi-square variable. This quantity distributed as a chi-square variable with the degrees of freedom equal to number of restrictions. number of restrictions. That is, lambda is equal to 2 ULLF minus RLLF. This quantity follows chi square with the, in this case, as there is only one restriction imposed, we have 1 degree of freedom. So we can test the validity of the restriction by using the chi square test. And if the value of the chi square is small, then ULLF and RLLF will be identical, not much different. What we say, null hypothesis will be accepted, restrictions will not be valid. If on the other hand, if the restriction is valid, this will be much larger than this. Sorry, this will be smaller than this. This will be unrestricted log likelihood function will be much smaller than this, and the chi square will be a big value. So naturally, the null hypothesis will be rejected, and we will say that the restriction is not valid. X3 will belong to the model. So the idea is, we calculate both the ULLF and RLLF. We formulate the test statistics, lambda as equal to, and this lambda follows chi square, and this procedure is the likelihood ratio test. Likelihood ratio test. And this likelihood ratio LR can also be written as minus 2 into LN lambda is equal to N into LN RSS minus LN unrestricted RSS quantity follows chi square with R degrees of freedom, where R is the number of restrictions. RSS is residual sum of squares from the restricted model, RSS from the unrestricted model. Now, given this is L follows chi square, then W is equal to N minus K into RRSS minus URSS by URSS follows chi square with R degrees of freedom. LM is equal to N minus K plus R into RRSS minus URSS by RRSS, again follows chi square with R degrees of freedom, where K is the number of regressors in the unrestricted model and R is the number of restrictions. And in large samples, LR, W and LM will be identical. But in small samples, it can be shown that W is greater than or equal to LR, greater than or equal to LM. So this is the troika of likelihood ratio, Wald and Lagrange multiplier tests. And remember this, in most cases, T and F will be enough. In most cases which we study, T and F will be enough. But when you read a computer output, Stata or eViews, there are many situations in which Wald test statistics will be reported. Likelihood ratio test statistics will be reported. And Lagrange multiplier test statistics will be reported. And remember this, the test statistics associated with all these quantities is chi square, with the degrees of freedom given by number of restrictions. In large samples, all these will give identical results. And we will not calculate any of these. The softwares will give output. The only thing required is, these are all alternative to F test. And sometimes it will be given as Wald F test, like that. So remember this. These test statistics are based on the principle of the method of maximum likelihoods. We have a restricted log likelihood function and an unrestricted log likelihood function. Test statistics are derived by a comparison of this restricted and unrestricted log likelihood. Or we can write it also in terms of RSS from restricted and unrestricted models. RSS from restricted and unrestricted models. As you can see, if the restrictions are valid in terms of RSS, this will be much high compared to this. So chi square will be a very large value. So H0 will be rejected. Not valid, both will be more or less identical. Then null hypothesis will be accepted. And we will come across these test statistics in detail when we proceed.